I just want to share three scriptures that's fine with everybody. First off, how y'all doing? I haven't seen y'all in a minute. Glad to see you. Now everybody's doing okay. This first scripture I want to touch on is in the book of Deuteronomy. And my testimony, really, I just want to give all glory and honor and thanks unto God. You know, it's a lot of things I can thank him for, but mostly for waking me up to the truth. You know, it's a lot of things our people don't know. So Deuteronomy 7:6 reads, "For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth." Now, when I first read that, it really kind of touched home because, you know, I look at my people, blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, and I can relate to that scripture. When I look at the things we're doing, the monuments we build, our history, how they want to draft us for the NBA, NFL, we are better. We are better people than everybody else on this earth, but our people, we don't see that. So when I read that scripture, it had me thinking, who are the Israelites? Because that's what it was talking about, right? And I'm like, clearly it can't be talking about the people who call themselves the Jews today, you know, that wear the hats and the little sideburn things. That can't be them. So when I started doing my research, you know, I found people who live over there in Israel actually who said that according to the Bible and prophecy, that the real Jews, according to the Bible, are the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans here in America. Now, at first I didn't believe it until I read Hosea, which is my next scripture. It's Hosea chapter 1, verse 10. It says, "Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea, which cannot be measured nor numbered. And it shall come to pass that in the same place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God." Because when we came here, they told us it was nothing more than Negroes, spics, savages, but it says in the same place it's going to be told that we are the children of Israel. So-called blacks and Latinos, we don't know our history pre-slavery. If you ask somebody, they're going to think we were swinging from trees in Africa, not even knowing that we built up great civilizations over there. Not knowing that if you go into Mexico, they have monuments showing the Ten Commandments written in Hebrew. That the Native Americans, that was their native tongue. So why is it that we are the only people on this earth who don't have a land to call our own? Because you can't claim Africa, that's the whole continent. There's many countries inside of it. We the only people who don't have our own language, our own culture, nothing, right? So going through that, I started to understand that we are the children of Israel, but with that, it came a lot of responsibility. A lot of people don't know that God only chose one people to be a God too, right? You look at Jesus Christ, they say he's a white man, but according to the Bible, it says that he was a man of color, which I'm gonna read for you right here, Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. It says, "His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow." So he had woolly gray hair, right? It says, "And his feet, his eyes were a flame of fire." So he had red eyes because he drank wine, of course. "And his feet like unto brass." Brass is already brown, right? It says, "And as if they burned in a furnace."
Excuse me, young man.
That means a dark, dark brown.
Young man.
So with that being said, our people, that's why we try to teach our people the truth, because we've been lied to.
Excuse me.
And that's the
man,
whole purpose of the Israelite music.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. That's not a testimony in the Church of God.
That is a testimony. Y'all
no, no,
truth.
See, you coming in here with something different.
Yeah. Man.
You coming in here with something different.
It's out the Bible.
I understand what's out the Bible.
And it's true.
I know what's in the Bible.
That is a revelation of Jesus Christ.
But the testimony is something that God did for you.
He woke me up to the truth. Before me reading the Bible, I was brought up all 17 years of my life thinking that God loved everybody, when according to the Bible, he said he only loves the children of Israel. I was brought up knowing that the laws of the Old Testament was done away with, yet tithing is a law in the Old Testament.
Young man, you come
and also that our Lord and Savior is a dark-skinned man.
Excuse me. I have
so that is my testimony.
Right now, because you bring confusion in here in the church. And this is not what we bring confusion in at. This is a place where we come in and we worship God. We're not coming to bring confusion.
Right.
That's confusion.
Right. How so?
When you read this Bible, you read this Bible not out of your mind, but your spirit.
Correct.
And in your spirit, God loves everybody. Because God created all men.
That's true.
He created all. He didn't just create me and you.
That's true.
He created all. Now, see, I used to be into the Islam where I had a hate. Hold on. We don't do it. Hold on. I had a hate against the Caucasian race. But when I came into the knowledge of Christ, and I came into His knowledge, I came to know that He loved not only me, but He loved him too.
Right.
Because he don't want me hating. See, what he want me to do is to serve him with a pure heart.
How do you do that?
By just doing what he tell me to do.
Which is the laws, right?
No. Yes, now, we don't live under the law.
That's not true.
We don't live under the law.
What's the fourth commandment?
Okay.
We don't live under the law. We're not going to go into verbatim discussion about this. Okay. We're not going to go into verbatim discussion. We're going to stop this right now. No, we don't need any more for you to say anything. Okay. Close your Bible. Vita, I got this taken care of.
Okay. Hey, Azar. The fourth commandment out of the Ten Commandments says, remember the Sabbath day.
You guys are filming in the church.
The Sabbath day is the seventh day of the week. Sunday is the first day of the week.
Sorry, but you guys are wrong.
So this is why we got to wake up, y'all.
This is not of God. That is not of God.
Let's get this.
So can I tell you
something? Let's get it. So we just got kicked out of the Christian church because they did not want to hear the truth.
You did not get kicked out of the Christian church because as a child of God, I know the truth. And just because I don't believe what you believe I'm talking about your beliefs.
It's in the Bible.
You guys are not in the right Bible.
I'm going to read this. Genesis chapter 2. Verse 3, it says, and God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made. The fourth commandment says, remember the Sabbath day. God said the Sabbath day is the seventh day of the week. Why are you going to church on the first day of the week?
Show them that the children of Israel are black, according to the Bible. He said that's not true.
Look, I don't even want to talk to you about it.
You don't want to talk about the Bible?
Not you.
Not about the Bible? See, this is why we got to come out of the Christian church, y'all. Christian pastors don't even want to deal with the Bible. Let me show you that the children of Israel, according to the Bible, not according to what man says, they are dark-skinned people.
Songs of Solomon. Songs of Solomon.
You're going to go to the book of Song of Solomon, chapter 1, and verse 5. Spirit of the devil, all right. Now I'm bringing truth, something you stop. You need to stop lying to the people. You got to stop lying to the people, man. Simple as that. So the book of Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5, says, I am black but comely. Why is it that they have a white man hanging on a cross in there? This is an Israelite king, King Solomon. He says, I am black but comely, O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar, as the curtains of Solomon. Look not upon me because I am black, because the sun hath looked upon me. Because when a dark-skinned brother get in the sun, he gonna get darker. But point being, flee the Christian church. It is not the truth, and they do not care about your soul. They're stealing your money. They're going to tell you that the laws of the Old Testament are done away with, yet they're going to keep tithing, which is the law of the Old Testament. So the Bible tells you, we gave them the truth. They didn't want to listen. So the Bible tells you in Matthew chapter 10, verse 14, and whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your words, when ye depart out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet. So we're going to do exactly just that. We don't deal with all foolishness. We came in here peaceably trying to give our people the truth. They didn't want to hear it. And you can see that the pastors are wicked as hell because they don't want to let the people hear the truth. We dealt with the Bible and they don't want to deal with that. So once more, we are out of here.